And the Islamic nations have gone from leading the world to being treated with scorn and derision. At this time of intellectual ignorance amongst the Islamic world, it is the great challenge for Ahmadi Muslim scientists and researchers to revive the honor and dignity of Islam in the global academic arena. Indeed, it should be your ambition to take up the glorious mantle of enlightenment adorned by the great Muslim scholars and inventors of the Middle Ages. Each year, it is a tradition that our Jamaat awards gold medals for outstanding educational achievements in various fields. However, when this scheme was initiated by Hazrat Khalifatul Masih III, Rahimahullah Ta'ala, he instructed that the gold medals and scholarships were specifically to reward those who excelled in science. He started the scheme shortly after Dr. Abdul Salam Sahib won the Nobel Prize, and it was his ardent desire that at least 100 Ahmadi Muslims would soon follow in the footsteps of Dr. Abdul Salam and become eminent scientists by the time our Jamaat entered its second century. Three decades of the second century of Ahmadiyya have now passed. I do not think we have produced even a scientist who has become world-renowned in that time. In addition, for the past 13 or 14 years, I have instructed Ahmadi students, either directly or through Majlis Khudam Ul Ahmadiyya, to enter the field of academia and research, and to endeavor to reach the highest echelons of their fields. However, so far, it cannot be said that the results have been anywhere near as good as I had hoped. As far as I know, hardly any Ahmadi has played an outstanding or extraordinary role in the scientific and intellectual development of the world. Here, I would also like to appreciate the efforts of the USA chapter of the Association of Ahmadi Scientists, who is somehow active and holds regular meetings on science and the Quran. Yet we cannot say they too have achieved that exceptional mark that is expected from them. Consequently, having gathered here and held this conference, you must all consider it your mission to pursue excellence within your chosen fields. You must leave here with a firm determination in your hearts to follow in the footsteps of Dr. Abdul Salam and those outstanding Muslim scholars and researchers who left behind a rich legacy of knowledge many centuries ago. You must reflect upon how you can develop a greater understanding of the world and develop new technologies or systems through which humanity can benefit. As scientists and researchers, it is up to you to exercise your minds and talents to seek out the ways and methods to accomplish great feats of learning. You should stay in contact with one another, and particularly with those who are working in similar areas of research, and learn from each other. Through mutual discussion and coordination, you may be able to achieve better results. Work with diligence, passion, and above all, constantly seek the help of Allah the Almighty at every step of your academic journey, and keep His Majesty at the forefront of your minds. With these words, I pray that may Allah the Almighty enable you to flourish and to achieve great success in your fields of expertise. And may we soon come to witness the dawn of a new Islamic golden age of intellectual progress and advancement led by Ahmadi Muslims across the world. Ameen. Now, kindly join me in silent prayer. I mean...